went to this church, and I was there probably 2 weeks, that I heard a message. Been churched all my life, and maybe you have been too, and heard a message I'd never heard before. And that message that I was lost, and I knew that, and that I was a sinner in need of a Savior, and that God loved me so much that He died on the cross for me and my sins so that I could have life and have it more abundantly. That God loved me so much that He sacrificed Himself, His own Son, so that I could experience what life was. That I was dead in my trespasses and sins. And that Sunday morning I heard that message, and I heard that somebody loved me, and I went down and accepted Christ as my Lord and Savior. I didn't accept Him just as my Savior. I accepted Him that morning as Lord because I gave Him my whole life. I said, "You take it. I can do nothing with my life. You take my life and do with it what you will." I walked out of that church knowing one thing, and that was that God loved me. Nobody else did. My husband did, and I was about eighth on his priority list. Whenever he had time or got around to it, he would be there for me, and if it was convenient for him. My mother didn't. She committed suicide and was not there, and my father ended up marrying 2 weeks after my mother committed suicide and left town. So I had felt so unloved. But that morning, I knew that God loved me and that He had a plan for my life. Now, I would love to say from that moment on, everything was wonderful. But it wasn't. I was still married to Larry.
So I was glad that she did this religious thing that she was doing, because I envisioned her getting together with these little church ladies, and they could all start making quilts and collecting canned goods and knitting breech cloths for the Aborigines to cover up with, and that would be really good stuff, and she'd keep off my case and let me go do what it was that I was doing. But I found out that she had gone into conspiracy with these church ladies behind my back, and they had begun to pray for me. See, well, if I'd have known that, I'd have said, "Wonderful girl, just pray your sweet little Christian Twinkie heads off for all I care. It keeps you busy, do it." I couldn't care less. But something began to happen. I saw before my very eyes my wife begin to be transformed. She began to change.
God had so many wonderful things in His Word to straighten me out. Now, see, my focus had always been on Larry. If he'd get his life straightened out, we'd have a great marriage. But a funny thing happens when you come into a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. He takes your eyeballs off the other person and turns them around, and you begin to see yourself for what you really are. And I began to see that there were some things that needed to be changed in me. And God began that process of changing me before He did anything with Larry. And when I got into God's Word in the Bible, I grabbed hold of a promise in Psalm 37, 4 and 5 that says, "Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to Him, and He will do it." In other words, God was saying to me personally, "Sue, you put me first. You let me be your life, and I'll give you your heart's desire."
But when I saw God transform her, and I saw her love me, the most unlovable person who ever lived, I said, there's no explanation for that apart from Christ, whom she claims now dwells in her, and I cannot deny it. That's what I want, and I invited Christ to come into my life. And friends, He has not only transformed my wife, He has and is still in the process of transforming, changing both of us. He has given me a love for this woman I did not know was possible. He has given her a love for me I never knew was possible. The reality of His presence has become so real to us through the years.
And when you're secure in this love relationship, And you know that nothing, absolutely nothing, can separate you from the love of God, no matter what. Then you're able to reach out and love those that God places in your life.
It's right up there. See the birdie? Tweet, tweet. Tweet, tweet. Tweet, tweet, says the bird. Made the bird. God did that too.
As high as the heavens are over the earth, and wider than every sea, love without borders and grace beyond words, your heart runs river deep. You are always good. There is no end to your mercy, and your love will not run dry. Darkness may deepen and shadows may fall, but you will be faithful and true. There is peace in the vineyard, for hope conquers all, and we can depend on you. You are always good. There is no end to your mercy, and your love will not run dry. Oh, you are always good. There is no end to your mercy, and your love will not run dry. Nothing can separate us from your love, Lord. Nothing can separate us from your love, from your love. Nothing can separate us from your love, Lord. Nothing can separate us from your love, from your love.
Second Chronicles 16:9 says, "For the eyes of the Lord move to and fro throughout the earth, that he may find one boy, one girl, one man, one woman, whose heart is completely his. Do you belong to the Lord? Is your heart completely his? God's looking for that one whose heart is completely his. Come to know him and let him begin to transform you.